शटल रडार टोपोग्राफी मिशन और SRTM. दिस इज SRTM शेडेड रिलीफ एनाग्लिफ ऑफ Zagros Mountains. The SRTM Shuttle Radar Topography Mission was flown on an 11-day mission from 11 to 22 February 2000 of the Space Shuttle Endeavour. So this NASA image, as you see, used Landsat data to texture, means drape, the surface created using the SRTM elevation data. So now, let me introduce SRTM as the elevation data. You can also see the peninsula and Cape of Good Hope, South Africa, which are visible. So SRTM is an international research effort that obtained DEM, digital elevation model, on near globe scale from 56 degree to south to 60 degree north, to generate the most high resolution digital topographic database of Earth prior to the Aster GDM in 2009. Before that, before Aster, SRTM was the one which was giving you the DM of globe. Not that much coverage, but still, SRTM consisted of a specially modified radar system that flew on board the Space Shuttle Endeavour, which is based on older space-borne imaging radar C and X band SAR, synthetic aperture radar, previously used on the shuttle. And to acquire topographic or elevation data, the SRTM payload, payload was outfitted with two radar antenna. One antenna was located in the shuttle payload bay, the other a critical change from the previous one, allowing a single pass interferometry on the end of a 60 meter, that is 200 foot mast that extended from the payload bay once the shuttle was in space. So the technique employed is known as the interferometric synthetic aperture radar. So radar interferometry gives the elevation value. If we have two locations from where we can get the response of the radar imaging, the elevation models are arranged into tiles, each covering 1 degree of latitude and 1 degree of longitude. So the tiles are 1 degree by 1 degree and named according to their southwest corners, which follows that this one, N45E006, it stretches from 45 degree north to 6 degree east. And likewise for other values also, the resolution of the raw data is 1 arc second. 1 arc second is equivalent to 30 meter, but for US territory, for others it is 3 arc second, that is 90 meter resolution. A derived 1 arc second data, which includes the tree and other non-terrain features removed, covering the Australia, was made in November 2011. So the raw data was restricted for government use only. For the rest of the world, only the 3, that is the 90 meter data, was available. So each 1 arc second tile has 3601 rows, each consisting of 3601 16-bit big Indian cells. And the dimension of 3 arc second tiles, 1201 into 1201. The original SRTM elevation was a work calculator related to the WGS-84, World Geodetic System 84 ellipsoid, and then the EGM-96 geoid separation value was added to convert the height relative to the geoid for all the release products. The elevation model derived from SRTM data are used in GIS and many other fields. They can be downloaded freely over the internet, and their file format is .hgg for height. The SRTM is an international project spearheaded by US NGA, National Geospatial Intelligence Agency, and the US NASA. So NASA transferred the SRTM payload to the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum in 2003, and which is now on display. What about the no data area? SRTM void, you know, there are voids. Void filling with spline interpolation which you can see by certain software say GRASS, GIS. The elevation data set are affected by mountain and desert, no data areas. So these amounts to no more than 0.2% of the total area being surveyed, but can be a problem in an area where high relief is there, where you cannot get a proper response of the radar imaging. They affect the summit over 8,000 meters, most summits over 7,000 meters, many alpine and similar summits and ridges, many gorges and canyons. So there are some SRTM data sources which have filled these data voids, but some of these have used only interpolation from surrounding data and may therefore be inaccurate sometimes. If the voids are large or completely cover summit or ridges areas, no interpolation algorithm will give this satisfactory result. So other developers including NASA, World Wind and Google Earth have improved their result by using 1 arc second for the US and 3 arc second for the rest of the world. So data in the interpolation process, but due to the poor resolution of this data, very poor quality of some of them, they have further improved this Earth viewing services by adding data from certain other sources. You know, you can examine Google Earth software. This can examine an example of most recent result, like you can just go to Mount Interest and tilt the image. This is a void filled SRTM data set, relief map for Sierra Nevada. This is the example of relief, as you can see, map for SRTM, same place, Central Nevada. Groups of scientists have worked on algorithms to fill the voids of the original SRTM data. So we have two data sets which offer global coverage, void filled SRTM data at full resolution, CGIAR, CSI versions and USGS hydro sheds data sets. These version 4 CGIAR provide the best global coverage full resolution SRTM data set, while the hydro sheds data was generated by hydrological application and is suitable for consistent drainage and water flow information. So references are always there for the algorithm use in quality assessment. The void filled SRTM data from the viewfinder panoramas, and they are high quality at full SRTM resolution. And after that we have various data which is available. So in November 2013, NASA, this LP DAC released the NASA Shuttle Radar Topography Mission SRTM version 3, SRTM Plus, produced the collection with the all voids eliminated. So voids were filled primarily from the Aster GDM2 and secondary from the GMDTD 2010 USGS or NED, that is National Elevation Data Set for the United States and also some nearby parts. So highest resolution global release, US state government 2014 September 23 over a UN climate summit, that the highest possible resolution of global topographic data derived from SRTM mission would be released to public. So in addition to before the end of the same year, 1 arc second GDEM has been released. So most of the world has been covered by the data set, ranging from 54 degrees south to 60 degrees north latitude, except the Middle East and North Africa areas. Certain missing coverage of Middle East also were completed. So users in this June 2011 were confirmed to be 750,000, using the SRTM data topography data sets, and almost 221 countries from different countries have accessed the site. So this was a brief idea about the SRTM, and you should really look for Aster GDM also if you are really into the digital elevation model. Thank you so much.